Tell me what you think. What up, money fam? It's your boy G-Money78 here. Back at it again with a new episode of Yo G, That's Money. And look at my princess right there. How you doing, girl? You smell the food, don't you? Mwah. Go ahead. Go, grandma. All right, guys. So, as you see by the title, yes, I am making a Supa Toscana, which is a hearty soup from Tuscany, Italy. And it's one of my family's favorite dishes that I make because I make it damn good. So, we're going to get started with that. C'è la luna, mezzo mare, mamma mia, me mare da te. Figlia mia, cotta dure, mamma mia, te pensa tu. Se tu non la gangare, e dove vai, e dove ne sei, non sa se c'è manetene. All right, guys, so what I like to do is I like to cut my potatoes lengthwise in half, and then I cut them on a wedge. All right, guys, so a quick tip. When you're going to handle bacon, you want to cut them into pieces. It's good to put them in the freezer for about a half an hour to an hour so they get nice and firm, and it's easier to cut through. And that's what we have here. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna start with the bacon. So, in goes the bacon to the nice heavy pot. Now you use a wooden spoon and we're gonna brown it up. So you wanna keep stirring your bacon, get it nice and brown. So this is the first stage of seasoning your pot, because this is a one pot dish. Everything gets cooked in one pot and one pot only. So it's easy. All right, guys, so we crisped up bacon. I put it to drain the excess oil. And now I left a little oil in the bottom of the pot so that way the ground sausage won't stick. So we got about 12 sausages, 6 hot and 6 sweet ones. And into the pot they go to brown it up. So it's good to use a wooden spoon so you can break up the sausage meat. Turn it around, let it get brown. And you gotta keep an eye on this, or else you'll have just one log of sausage meat. And you don't want that. You want ground up sausage meat, evenly cooked. All right, guys, so we browned off the sausage meat. And I gotta tell you, my kitchen has a whirlwind of delicious smells. Like, it smells like sausage, it smells like bacon. We're not even done yet. All right, guys, so now we're moving on to the kale. And we got some beautiful, organic grown, curly kale. And we don't use the stem, the hard part, because you really have to cook it down for a long time. We only use the leaf. So all we do is we grab it from the bottom and then just strip it. Comes right off. So you can throw the stems out if you want, or you can do what I do. I collect them and I throw them into a juice, a smoothie. You know, there's a lot of nutrients in there. All right, guys, so we got the kale all stripped, washed, and cut. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna brown up some of the garlic, the onion, and then we're gonna get cooking. It's all coming together, guys. We're gonna start off by adding some extra virgin olive oil, just to coat the bottom of the pan, so that way we can brown up the garlic and the onion. So we're gonna start with the onion. Now I got about 5 cloves of garlic here. Oh wow, you can instantly smell the garlic. Nothing better than cooked garlic. So fragrant. It's one of my favorite things to use when I'm cooking. Now I got it at medium heat. I don't want to burn them. Just want to infuse the oil with the garlic. Now, at this point, we're going to throw in the onion. This is one whole white onion. Wow, now we're cooking, guys. This smells amazing. So we just want to cook this until the onions are translucent, you know, just a little soft. All right, guys, so now we've got the onion sweating, and now it's time to throw back in the meats. So here goes the bacon. Back in with the sausage. So now we're marrying the meat with the onion and the garlic. So they're gonna take on a whole nother flavor. And if you feel like your pot is a little dry, as you see mine, all you have to do is just add a little bit more of the extra virgin olive oil. It's time to dump in the kale. Now, if you think it's too much, don't worry, because it will wilt. All right, guys, so now we're gonna add some water. About two or three of these. All right, guys, so now we added the water to the pot. And if you see, if you notice, the kale is starting to wilt. So now we're gonna put the lid on it and we'll keep it at medium to high heat. And just keep checking on it. Alright, guys, now in goes the gnocchi, which are potato dumplings. You want enough water till everything is covered, as you see here. And now we're gonna put the lid on it, let it come up to a boil, and then you check the potatoes to see that they're tender enough but still have some bite to it. That's how I like my potatoes. So the potatoes, they're done. The kale is wilted, everything is good. Now we're just gonna season it a little bit before we add the heavy cream. So, a few pinches of sea salt, about that much of black pepper. And now we add a little heavy cream. So it's gonna end up being kind of a white, creamy color soup. All right, guys, so we're gonna let that boil away to warm up the cream, and then we'll be ready to plate. So we have some garlic bread, some Texas toast bread with garlic and parsley and butter, which is the perfect thing to eat with the Supa Toscana. And voila, this is my Supa Toscana with some garlic bread. Alright, guys, so shout out to today's camera woman, my cousin Soraya. And she came in to visit us. Yeah, so listen, you came in on the right day, the perfect day. I made the Supa Toscana, and there it is. And I want you to give it a taste. Tell me what you think.
Oh, wow. It looks great. Yo, G, that's money.
So there you have it. That's my Supa Toscana. It's delicious. It's amazing. I can't wait to dig in. So if you enjoyed this video and want to see more like these, please click like, share, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And Money Fam, I'll see you in the next one.